Dear students, now we'll solve problems from exercise 4.2. Problem number one. So here the problem number one is the page number 119, exercise 4.2 from the textbook. So the given determinant is given like this: x plus a, y b, y plus b, and z c, z plus c. So he has given, this is the determinant. Of course, you can refer it from your textbook. Directly, I am going to solve. So he has asked us to show that the value of this determinant is zero. The value of this determinant is zero. Suppose you take this one is delta. We have to show that the value of this determinant is zero now. See, dear students, the value of the determinant becomes zero at two conditions. Either any two rows or two columns must be identical, or all the elements in any row or column must be completely zeros. So, of course, to prove this one, you can expand by using any row or any column. You can expand and prove that. Instead of that, again, I told you this is the original body. So before going to the operation theater, so I'll do some operation on this. Sir, what operation you'll do here? Look at this. C1 plus C2. I'll add C1 plus C2 here. Look at here. XA and YB, ZC, and here it is same. C1 plus C2 means definitely you get here X plus A. Y plus B means here you get Y plus B, and Z plus C means here you get Z plus C. That means first column and third column will become identical, then automatically the answer remains zero. So what is the operation I'll take? That is taking, so what I'll take here, taking C1 plus C2 I'm going to take. Be careful. When C1 means, your handwriting should go like this. When row means, your handwriting should go like this. That means C1 plus C2. First, what is this? Columns. Look at this. This is the determinant. I'll tell you. So, space for column 1, space for column 2, space for column 3. First, I told you, this is the determinant before going to the operation theater. This is the determinant after coming out of operation theater. After operation. After surgery. I told you in the surgery, definitely, once if you do surgery, definitely there should be some small change in the body as well as rest of the body will be unchanged. So first unchanged. First you ask, always you ask yourself question, how many columns are there in the given determinant, in the original? C1, C2, C3. So this is the surgery I have decided to take now. This is the surgery. So in this surgery, first is what? C1 is visible. Remove this. That means these two are unchanged. And then before operation, after operation, they are unchanged. That is column 2 is unchanged. A, B, C. Column 2 unchanged, column 3 unchanged. X plus A, Y plus B, and Z plus C. Please learn this. Now the operation and result. Now I'm going to start the surgery now. C1 plus C2. Then definitely result will be, after adding, the new result will be added to C1 only. That means C1 is going to be changed now. That means this is called new C1 can be achieved, or new C1 can be formed by doing the surgery C1 plus C2 on original body. Yes, C1 plus C2, here I'm writing X plus A, right here, X plus A. C1 plus C2, Y plus B, Y plus B. And Z plus C. This is Z plus C. Delta. Dear student, now column 1 and here column 3 are identical. Column 1 and column 3 are identical here. identical. Therefore, the value of this determinant is zero. The value of this determinant is zero. So please make a note of this. And similarly, I'm going to solve one more example here. I'm going to solve one more example for you. This, yes. So I'm just going to solve one more problem in this case. Look here. Yeah. Please make a note of this problem. Look here. I'll keep this both the problems, but very simple. First, all the students try to understand the given determinant is a original body. On that, you are doing some surgery, that is operation. After operation, it is confirmed there must be some change and there must be some unchange also. Because once if you go to the operation theater, entire body will not be transformed and come. So the second example, what I am going to take this second example here, you see this. So in this case, so this one is, I think you have taken. Now I'm going to take one more example. Problem number 3, again he has asked this determinant to be proved as 0. Directly I'm going to take the determinant 2765, 2765, 3875, 3875, and 5986. Of course, you can see in the textbook, this determinant is also, he has asked us to prove that answer is 0. We have to prove this determinant is 0, 2765, 3875, 5986. So this determinant, we have to show that the answer is 0, value is equal to 0. Yes, all 9 elements are numbers. You want to go for expand, you can expand and show that the answer is 0. But my dear student, in the third column, the 2-digit numbers are there. So that you will be spending, you will be wasting a lot of time on only cross multiplication like plus 2, 886, minus 975. Next, you are expanding along row 1, minus 7, at 7, 386, 575. Next, third, plus 65, 39, 85. So that also you can try, but instead of that, this is again present right now, original body. I would decide to do some operation on this body. What operation I'll do it, my dear students? First, column 2, I'll multiply every element of column 2 by 9 times with 9 times of C2. The same will I am adding to column 1. Same I am going to add column 1. So that means, so this is the taking, I am taking this operation now. I have decided to do this operation. I have to C1 plus 9 C2. This is the type of surgery I want to do it on this old body, original body. Original body in this. First I told you, definitely after that, after this is the before operation. And after operation, definitely body will little bit change and come. This is after surgery. After surgery. This is our operation. What is first unchanged? We'll see. What is unchanged? This is the type of operation. How many columns are there? Column 1. That is, we are doing with column. You have to space for column 1, space for column 2, space for column 3. How many columns are there totally we have in the original given determinant? C1, C2, C3. First, go through the surgery. In the surgery, first, what is visible? C1. That you remove. In operation, whichever it is, first is visible. That you remove. That is, these two are unchanged. That means, C2, C3 will remain same for before operation before surgery and after surgery. So C2 is unchanged. I'll write as it is first. 7, 8, 9, 65, 75, and 86. That's now surgery. Surgery result will be visible here on the C1. Okay, now operation. C1 plus 9 C2. After doing this operation, I'm going to add the result. I'm going to write the result in C1 itself. That means definitely you find some new C1. Again, I'm telling you, new C1 will be formed by taking C1 plus 9 C2. Here you see that? Okay, C1, 2 plus 9 times of 7. You add it. Come on here. 2 plus 9 times of 7. What happened? 65. Here, result will be. Next, 3 plus 9 times of 8, 75. Next, 5 plus 9 times, C1 plus 9, C2. 9 times 81, that is 86. So here, once again, you understand the delta is 0, determinant is 0, because column 1 and column 3 here, again, same. So here, C1 and C2 are identical. Or identical. That is the reason these are the value of the determinant is 0. First, I told you this is before going to the operation theater. After coming from the operation theater, in that always remember minimum one row or one column should come unchanged from the original body to operated body. It should be. That's what beginners always catch unchanged first. Afterward, this is, see, here, 2, 3, 5 in the original body was column 1. 65, 75, 86 is after surgery, column 1 is this. That means new column has been formed here. That is the reason. How this new column 1 has been formed? By doing surgery C1 plus 9 C2 on the original body. So this is two problems, very simple, small examples I have taken. Please note down. Thank you, my dear students. Thank you.